What's going on, everybody? This may look a little different. I am in a yak. I'm actually at my girlfriend's house. She lives on a lake, which is nice. Not why I'm dating her, by the way. And I'm in her cousin Chaz's yak. He let me use, his name's Chaz, so shout out to you, Chaz, for letting me borrow your yak today. I wanted to get out. We're gonna do a little topwater sesh today. Hopefully some frogs. I brought the plopper, and then, you know, the old stank of the classic. I haven't filmed here in a long time, though. It's been a while. It's been a long time since you guys have seen me film here. It's probably been like at least a year when I used to do like the 1v1s against my girlfriend. A lot of them happened here. So I don't know if I'm gonna catch any fish. I have not fished this on like a boat or a yak in a year. So I have no idea if there are any fish in here left or anything like that. But it's gonna be fun. I wanted to mix it up. I know a lot of you guys have kayaks. And for those of you youngsters that really wanna get out away from the bank, I would totally recommend a kayak. John boats are cool. Like, I love my little John boat, but you know, it's got an engine, it takes gas, it costs money for repairs if it breaks. Like, this thing is like literally zero to no maintenance. And I honestly don't really have a preference on kayaks. I have a couple different ones. You know, I like them all, really. I would just find what fits your budget, to be completely honest with you. You know, I wouldn't sit here and not go fishing for an entire year because you're saving up for one of the expensive ones. Like, buy the cheapest one that you can find, or buy, like, you know, the one that you can afford and get out away from the bank and go catch some fish. So that's my advice to you folks, not even young folks, just folks in general that want to go fishing. It's very key that you get away from the bank. The bank is fine, but if you really want to advance your skills, you need to get away, either on a boat or a yak, or if, I guess in Perry's case, maybe like a pool floaty or something like that. But anyways, I'm gonna stop talking. We're gonna see if we can catch some fish today. I'm starting off with the old topwater froggy hoggy. I do have a plop daddy tied on. I might throw that a little bit. There is some open water, but I see some vegetation down yonder. So, wow, this feels weird fishing out of a yak for sure. Have not done this in quite some time. One thing I hate about yak fishing is setting the hook. You guys see how I set the hook? I set the hook like a freaking idiot. Yeah, try doing that out of a floating raft like this. It's not easy. I almost fall out. I've got a couple $1,000 worth of camera gear and tackle in here, so my goal today is to not fall out. Otherwise, if it does, you guys need to view this video like 10 times each so I can make my money back to buy a new camera and new tackle. Oh, that's saucy cast right there. Come on. Come on, fish. Ooh. Ooh. Oh, there's a frog. I don't want chill. Now, you stay right where you are, buddy. Oh, goodness. That was a giant carp. Oh, I just had a giant bass right there. Whoa, what the hell? Okay, all right, Flair, pay attention. What are you doing with your life? All right, I'm gonna move spots. I tried the old plop daddy, tried the frog, tried the stanko, only had the one. The old one bass come and hit my frog. I think this side's a little too shallow. Last time I fished this like a year ago, the water was up like another probably foot and a half, 2 feet. This side's looking a little shallow. I'm gonna basically haul butt to the other side as quickly as possible. Before that sun gets up, I really wanna catch some topwater fish today. There's a fish, first one. Oh, thank goodness, on the old stanko. Come here, buddy. Ooh, that's actually a good one. Okay. You guys have grown in the last year, I see. There we go, folks, first one right there. That's actually pretty big. Last year, the size in here wasn't very, very, very large, but I'll take that guy right there. See you, buddy, whoop. Back in the water she goes. That was on the old green pumpkin stanko. For some reason, they just were not feeling the old frog this morning. I don't know what the deal was. I had great conditions, but they just, I mean, they would chase it, and they would chase it to the old yak and scare the piss out of me, but they wouldn't actually eat it. So I switched up to something a little bit more subtle, something that's easy for them to bite, and just pitching on these the weed edges, basically. So instead of fishing in the weeds with a frog, fishing on the weed edges with a stanko, and I'm about to eat this branch here. There's one on a frog. There we go. I think I might have found the juice, folks. There's a little running creek here. I always talk about running water in my videos. I just found the only spot that's running water since the water is so low. And I just saw like four bass chase this frog, and I actually landed one. So these are the squeakers that I thought were kind of the size last year, but I don't know. We'll see. We'll see how many squeakers are up there. That little dude munched the frog right there. Finally, finally a topwater fish. See you, buddy. Whoop! There he goes. Like I said, I think I found the juice. I'm gonna make another cast in there. I just had one strike, I missed him, threw back in there, caught that one, and had two more that like kind of hit at the same time as that last one. So I think I might have found the sauce. Ooh, right there. Come on, eat it, eat it. Just saw a fish. I just saw a fish. They're up here. There they are.
There it is, right there.
Yep. Yep, there she is. Not a giant. Come here, buddy. I'll take them, though. That's exactly what I was saying. Hit them with that 1-2 Senko punch and you catch yourself a fish. Nice, pretty little bass. Back in the water she goes. So yeah, you can kind of see the creek now. It kind of flows in. Unfortunately, the water's so low. Normally, you can actually catch fish back there. But the water is so low that I highly, highly doubt that you could actually catch anything back there. But what they do is they'll congregate right at the mouth, because what it does is when that thing's flowing, that's gonna be blowing bait fish and microorganism for the bait fish. And you know, any wounded bait fish is gonna get swept away in there. And then they just kind of sit there right there. And it's a nice funnel. It's a nice funnel for the fish. Hopefully you guys are enjoying these hand gestures. I'm trying to explain and help you guys catch fish if you have something like this on a lake or a pond near you. There's one.
There's one. That's a good one. Yep, that's a good fish.
Yes, sir. Oh, yeah. Here we go. Here we go. Now we're talking, folks.
Come here, buddy.
It's about the size of that first one. The old Stanko fish just dragging this thing on the bottom. I don't know why they're being so, like, lethargic today. There we go. That's much better. That's much better than that first, or the last couple, I guess I should say. The first one is actually pretty good. This one's a lot bigger than those other two. I'll take that guy right there. See, buddy. Whoop. Hell yeah. Sorry that I'm catching him on a Stanko, guys. I know you guys give me a lot of grief when I do that, just because I do it a lot. I really haven't done it in the last few videos, though. I mean, I've really, really tried to get out of my comfort zone, throw like swim jigs and stuff like that. Something just a little bit different. But today I'm going back to my roots. The old Stanko wins again. When they don't want topwater and it's calm, guys, weightless Texas rig Stanko, just like that. It is pretty hard to beat. And you just want to match the color to the water clarity. So like right now it's pretty clear here. So I'm using green pumpkin. I could use watermelon. But I mean, I've got a few foot visibility. If it's a little bit stained, a little bit muddy, you want to go with more of like a black and blue color. But weightless Texas rig Stanko. You guys see it all the time. I catch lots of fish on it. You can catch big fish. I know you guys are seeing me catch a lot of flare fish today. Unfortunately, this lake is not jam-packed with toads. But at least I'm catching some fish. There's a fish.
Yep, good and
good and good and folks, and I'm eating good. Yes, sir. As much as like I don't really like kayak fishing, I really do love kayak fishing, if that made any sense. It's like so much more of a challenge to try to land these things. Look at that thing just flopping around all over. Come here, buddy. Oh, you quit that. You stop it. No, that's more the size we're looking for. That's actually not quite as big as I thought, but you know, I'll take it. That's a solid 2.5 pounder right there. See, little buddy? Whoop. That's a good fish. That is a good fish, folks. We're on to something. That was on the old Stanko again. We're on to something. There's some weeds. I don't know how well you guys can see it. There's weeds here. I'm casting on the weed lines right where the water kind of drops off, just letting this thing sink all the way down to the bottom, not moving it. And then when you pick up on it, that's usually when you have the fish, which is when I had that bite as well. So a little tip on how to Stanko fish, you don't do a whole lot. Throw it out there, let it sink down to the bottom. And if you don't have a bite, you're probably not gonna get one on that cast anyway. Otherwise, you just kind of hop it along, kind of like a jig, a little Texas rig, and let it sink down. Just super subtle, catches lots and lots of bass.
There's one. There's one.
Yeah, he hit the Senko on the top water. I didn't set the hook right away because I didn't think he had it. That's a freaking good one. That's a good one right there, boys. Right there. Yep. Dude, the donkeys are back here. This is where they're at. This is where they're at. Two good fish in this back little cove area. I didn't think they'd be shallow like this, but they are. There we go. Look at that. I think that might be the heaviest one of the day. That's 2.5 at least. I'm about to crash here. I'll take that guy. Nice little chunker. See you, buddy. Back in the water she goes, folks. Hell yeah, that was kind of a surprise. I hadn't caught a fish in a while back here. But then that one, I cast and it literally hit the water and there was an explosion, like similar to a topwater frog. And it was a fish. Basically grabbed it, ran out deep, set the hook, bam.
There we go. Swimming. Swimming this thing, Kyle.
That's another good fish, actually. Oh, wow. They want this thing moving today. I don't know why they wouldn't eat a topwater, like a whopper plopper or anything, but this dude ate it swimming in. A little swimming Zanko action. Not a toad, but I'll take it. Not quite in the nursery. Not a toad, but we're not in the nursery. We're doing all right, folks. We're doing all right. Another little Zanko fish. See you, buddy? Whoop! Back in the water she goes.
2 hours later.
How's it going, everybody? Ending the video here. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the kayak fishing video. I had a lot of comments. Lots and lots of comments asking me to go kayak fishing, because I know a lot of you guys use kayaks. A lot of you guys are looking into getting some kayaks. And like I said at the beginning of this video, I'll tell you right now, if you have the money, get a kayak. Get a kayak. I don't care what brand it is. It doesn't matter. They're all the same, in my opinion. I mean, some of them have little quirks that are better than others, but in reality, as long as you're floating and not sinking, you're good to go. I don't even know what I was in today, but I've got a couple different branded ones, and they all work the same. So go to your local retailer or online and buy one, whether it's $2,000 or $200. It doesn't matter. Get in a kayak. This is not like a plug for kayaks necessarily. This is just trying to help you guys catch more fish and become better anglers. Getting off of the bank is the biggest leap in like becoming a better angler, is being able to get offshore. And granted, I beat the bank today. You guys saw me. I threw a Zanko and a frog up against the bank all day. So what do you guys are probably thinking, well, why couldn't I do that from the bank? You can. One, you're a lot more efficient because I can cover a lot more water. And two, that's not always what I'm doing. Sometimes I'm throwing a little bit deeper and whatnot. But anyways, I'm not gonna make this video any longer. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the kayak video. If you did, leave a like, make sure you hit that subscribe button, and let me know down below if you liked it. If you want to see more, I can do more. I have two kayaks that I can take anywhere. That one was just, Macy's cousin's kayak. So he let me borrow that for the day today, make that video possible. So thank you guys so much for watching. Really do appreciate you guys tuning in. I am headed down to Bobby Guy's place. Actually, by the time you're watching this, I probably was already there. I don't know when I'm posting this video, but I'm doing some crazy stuff. Crazy stuff. I'm leaving tomorrow. Gonna do some stuff that I may or may not regret. Fairly dangerous things. Anyways, peace.